British villains love Jaguars. They're menacing and unmistakably aristocratic. But what about the weekend, when these villains want to go out with their families for a long drive? In that case, they'd probably park their F-Type at home and take this. The XF S Sportbrake. Most car enthusiasts that I know love a fast sport brake. I love one too. It's just something about all of that performance in all of that shape that attracts everyone's attention. But does it deserve it? Let's find out. The XF S Sportbrake isn't everyone's cup of tea, especially in this region. The Germans, with their very competitive and capable lineup, have a far higher market share in this segment. Not just here, but globally. And I think that's a bit of a bother for Jaguar. The only Sportbrake Jaguar sold before this one was the X-Type Sportbrake. And that was based on a Ford Mondeo chassis and didn't do that well globally. So why bother building another one? That's because Jaguar today isn't your conventional stick-to-the-rules kind of a car company. Jaguar's hoping the Sportbrake carves a niche within a niche, a sporty performance driver's car that offers all the space of a crossover but doesn't sit that high up and corners like a sports car. The XF S Sportbrake comes with only one drivetrain configuration. And I don't think anyone's gonna complain about that. It gets a supercharged V6 that puts out 380 horsepower, which is then sent to all four wheels via an 8-speed automatic transmission. Now, even though it has more power than its direct competitors, the gearbox doesn't react as quickly as I'd like it to. But I don't think that's a deal breaker. In fact, once you drop your family home from the supermarket run, you can drive it straight to the track and go to town with it. And thank God for superchargers. I love the linear power delivery on this engine. No more turbo lag nonsense. Matching the performance is a body style that's complemented with red brake calipers, 19-inch alloy wheels, a sleek spoiler, a massive sunroof, twin exhaust, and a dark hex aluminum finish inside the car. My verdict? The XF S Sportbrake gets top points in the looks department. If you're looking to buy an SUV with space and practicality in mind, you could either buy the F-Pace or this. Now, personally, I'd prefer this, because this does everything the F-Pace does, but it also offers a sporty drive. The XF S Sportbrake sits between the Prestige and the bonkers XFR Sportbrake model. Now, the range starts at 230,000 dirhams. This one is, and brace yourself, a whopping 410,000 dirhams. Now, that's the price you pay if you want an all-wheel drive, slick, supercharged estate befitting a British villain.